Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi and asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, so others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning to you all. Dear brothers and sisters, assembled here, the Word of God has invited us to find an answer to Jesus' question. Jesus has answered, questioned us, "Who do people say I am?" And of course, Peter, on our behalf, he has said, "People say that you are John the Baptist. Others say you are Elijah. And others say still you are Jeremiah or one of the prophets." And Jesus turns to us, the 12, say, "But you, who do you say I am?" And Peter again says, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus is here in our midst because he said, "Where two or three are gathered in my name, I am in their midst." He's here and he's asking each and every one of us, this congregation, "What do you say I am?" It could be difficult for us to answer, but we could also travel the journey Peter traveled. And that's a daily encounter with Jesus, being with him, listening to him, and seeing him do things. That's the traveling of the journey of discipleship, to encounter him through our victories, through our failures, and through our weaknesses. It is through these encounters that we shall draw closer to him and come to know him deeper. But we also need the Spirit. Jesus has told Peter, "It's not flesh that has revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven." So we need also to be enlightened by the Spirit to work in us and to be in our lives so that he may be able to explain to us the mystery of Christ. But I think we also can ask him, "Jesus, who am I for you?" I am John Baptist Kagwa the Bishop of Masaka Diocese in Uganda, in East Africa. Uganda borders with Kenya in the east, and it borders with Southern Sudan in the north, and it borders with the Democratic Republic of Congo in the west, and it borders with Tanzania and Rwanda in the south. Uganda shares the waters of Lake Victoria with Kenya and Tanzania. Uganda has a population of 34 million people, and these are majorly divided into three denominations: the Catholics, Anglicans, who are Christians, and then the Muslims. The Catholic community in Uganda is divided into 19 dioceses, and Masaka is one of those. It has a population of 2 million Catholics and is divided into 54 parishes and 800 mission churches, or call them sub-parishes, which are under the leadership of the lay catechist, who keep the faith alive and expressed until when a priest is able to visit them. And usually a priest's visit is filled with multiple sacramental celebrations. Unlike the USA, there is little means of personal support for the diocesan clergy. No social security, no health care benefits, little, if at all, to any salary. And when resources permit, I'm only able to give $15 to a priest in a month. So my priests have no safety nets, even for those who are retired from active ministry. Last year, I lost a young priest, and he was suffering from brain tumor. He had been referred to India for further treatment, but because the diocese did not have resources, by the time we mobilized the monies he needed, it was too late. And as I was leaving the country to come to this country of yours, one of my priests fell sick, and seriously sick. He was rushed to the hospital, a public hospital, but he could not be admitted nor treated because we didn't have the cash that was being demanded for his hospital bills. So these are sad moments for a bishop, especially to look after and care for his immediate collaborators. Now, with dwindling subsidies from Rome, there is a challenge to be innovative and have investment projects towards self-sufficiency. In our diocese, we have resolved to put up to construct a banking hall as a project, and it's going to be hired by the Centenary Bank. So the proceeds from the rent will be helping the priests at least to meet some of their social needs. With the 2 million people, we have exhausted their resources. They have been so generous. They have been able to put the building where it is. The bank needs the building by the end of this November, and we don't have the funds. So that's why I have come to the USA, and that's why I am here in Buffalo, and that's why I visited you this Sunday, the community of St. Gregory, to make a missionary appeal. The building, to complete it, will cost us $106,500,000 Uganda money, and that is equivalent to $30,000. And I know that the people of St. Gregory are generous. By the way, I was warned that at this time being summer, the people don't need long talks. And someone told me that the longer you make it, the less generous the people will be. And another one told me that the shorter you are, the greater the generosity. And therefore, I stop here wishing you a good Sunday.